And overall, it sounds like Trishea will be a very useful hero. I'm definitely going to build her, especially since she's a welder. It's pretty easy to build these main four faction heroes. Combined with how good she looks, the whole space theme I really like I said. And yeah, just the fact that she's a part of the main four faction heroes, I will definitely be building Trishea. So we have Trishea, the new wilder hero. So Trishea is also an intelligence-based hero, it looks like, as well. Also going to be a mage class, and the primary role is continuous damage. So let's start by looking at the skills here, starting with the ultimate skill. So the ultimate skill is called Stellar Guide. It has a passive ability here first. Trishea observes the universe and changes her normal attack according to the guidance of the stars in the form of either luminance or eclipse. After following the guidance, she receives one Feathers of Fate. With luminance, she deals small AoE damage to all enemy heroes for 100% of Trishea's attack rating. And with Eclipse, she deals damage to the enemy hero with the highest health for 300% of Trishea's attack rating. And the active ability of this ultimate skill, when using the skill, her feathers float to form a glittering arc, dealing damage for 300% of her attack rating to enemies on the path. To use her ultimate skill, Trishea requires 7 feathers but does not consume energy. Trishea cannot receive energy when her skill Starlight Plumes is still locked. And level 2, damage dealt to enemies on the path is increased to 350% of Trishea's attack rating. And level 3, damage dealt to enemies on the path is increased to 400% of Trishea's attack rating. I'm really liking this so far. She goes according to the guidance of the stars to determine whether she uses luminance or eclipse here. And also, it looks like she's going to be doing quite a bit of damage here with the active ability. The thing is, she needs 7 feathers here to do her ultimate skill, but she does not consume energy, which is pretty interesting. A lot of the other heroes need their energy bar to be full, but she needs 7 feathers here to do her ultimate, it looks like. And moving on to the second skill, we have Starlight Plumes. This is a passive ability, it looks like, as well. Trishea recovers energy, but an energy recovery that is reduced by 90%. The energy she receives each time does not exceed 50 points. For every 200 energy points possessed, she gains 2 points of Magic Pierce. And level 2, for every 200 energy points possessed, Magic Pierce received by Trishea is increased to 4 points. Level 3, for every 200 energy points, Magic Pierce received by Trishea is increased to 6 points. And level 4 reduces energy recovery to 60%. So it's just reducing the energy recovery that she gets here. With level 4, it reduces it to 60%, which is better, a little bit better than the 90% that we have here. Also, she's gaining some magic pierce as well. And this might sound pretty bad, but just remember, in order to do the ultimate skill, you need to have 7 feathers. So the energy does not really matter, I don't think, with her. As much as other heroes, at least. And moving on to the third skill, we have Destiny Teller. This has another passive. She's having a lot of passive abilities here. Trishea's outcome from observing the universe and receiving guidance becomes more stable. The more surviving enemy heroes, the more likely the guidance will be luminance. And when there are 5 surviving enemy heroes, the chance of receiving luminance are 100%. The fewer surviving enemy heroes, the more likely the guidance will be Eclipse. And when there is only 1 surviving enemy hero, the chances of receiving Eclipse are 100%. And level 2, damage from Luminance and Eclipse are increased to 130% and 390% of Trishea's attack rating, respectively. Level 3, Luminance and Eclipse reduce the defense rating of damaged enemies by 40% for 4 seconds. And we have the first engraving skill. Damage dealt by enemy heroes hit by luminance within 1.5 seconds does not exceed 10% of the max health of their target. Each enemy can trigger this effect once every 4 seconds. Damage taken by enemy heroes each time they are hit by eclipse within 1.5 seconds is at least 300% of Trishea's attack rating. Each enemy can trigger this effect once every 4 seconds. that essentially the more heroes you have on the battlefield, the more, or the more enemy heroes that are alive on the battlefield, the more, the higher chance Trishea will use Luminance, and the least surviving enemy heroes there are on the battlefield, the more likely she'll use Eclipse. And it looks like it's trying to reduce the damage the enemies deal here. From Luminance, the damage does not exceed 10% of the max health of their target. Yeah, pretty interesting engraving skill here, it looks like. And let's go move on to the final skill we have, Astral Mystery, another passive. So yeah, it looks like a lot of the damage is going to be dealt by Luminance and Eclipse. Each feather received by Trishea causes her ultimate skill, Stellar Guide, to deal additional effects to enemies. Each feather received after Eclipse increases damage taken by the target by 5% for 6 seconds. Each feather received after Luminance deals additional health loss to the target for 30% of Trishea's attack rating. After she uses her ultimate skill, Stellar Guide, the additional effect will be reset. And level 2 increases damage buffs dealt by each feather of fate received after Eclipse to 10%. Level 3 increases health loss dealt by each feather of fate after Luminance to 50% of Trishea's attack rating. And the second engraving skill we have, when using her ultimate skill at full energy, Trishea will immediately use the ultimate skill once more. The additional effects granted to the ultimate skill from the skill Astral Mystery will be reset after the ultimate skill is used again. So yeah, really gaining those Feathers of Fate, allowing the ultimate skill to do additional effects to the enemies here. Yeah, increased damage here, also additional health loss as well. And with the second engraving skill, when you have her energy bar full, she will do her ultimate ability again, which I don't know how useful that will be, considering with the second skill, the energy is being reduced by 90% or 60%, depending on how well you have her built, or how well you have her leveled up, I guess. Okay, let's move on to the signature item here. So it's called Cosmic Revelation. When you unlock the signature item, while observing the universe, Trishea is immune to control effects. So right off the bat, being immune to control effects when you unlock here, when she's observing the universe, that sounds very nice. That sounds very useful. And unlocking at plus 10, while observing the universe, Trishea receives 35% damage reduction. So also sounds very nice. Plus 20, each Feather of Fate received by Trishea permanently increases her initial attack rating by 2%. And plus 30, each Feather of Fate received by Trishea permanently increases her initial attack rating by 4%. So it doesn't sound like there's going to be any limit on how many Feathers of Fate you can receive. It just says that when you get 7 Feathers of Fate, she'll use her ultimate. So if she can use her ultimate multiple times, it sounds like there could be pretty much an infinite amount of Feathers of Fate you can get here. So that sounds like when you get the attack rating up quite a bit, that sounds very useful there. And I'm going to move on to the exclusive furniture, and it's called Oracle's Notes. With the 3 of 3, for every 50 energy points received, Trishea immediately receives 1 Feather of Fate, up to 20 Feathers of Fate. Such Feathers of Fate will render the additional effects granted by Trishea's ultimate skill the same as those granted by the Feathers of Fate for the last time she received guidance. So, 1 Feathers of Fate for every 50 energy points, up to 20 Feathers of Fate, and just like with the signature item increasing, permanently increasing the attack rating of her, so that could be pretty useful. And 9 of 9, when Trishea's energy is full, she receives 1 Feather of Fate every 3 seconds. Such Feather of Fate will render the additional effects of Trishea's ultimate skill the same as those granted by the Feathers of Fate the last time she received guidance. So getting that energy bar full for those additional Feathers of Fate, that sounds like a pretty good exchange there. Overall, the furniture sounds very good. Everything about her sounds very good. I really like this whole space theme. I really like space, and I built Audrey and Moriel, the two, I guess, space-themed other celestial heroes. And I kind of want to see what her skills look like, so I'm going to go into the Arena of Trials. I believe it's already started on the test server, so I'm just going to look at what her skills look like. So I'm just going to go over to the wooden dummy here, and this will just show just her using her skills here. And there we go. I think I'm going to turn it off times two speed just so I can see this more closely. And it looks like right here, looks like it's showing the Feathers of Fate around her. It looks like she has 5 right now. Got those 5 Feathers of Fate pretty fast here. And as soon as she gets to 7, there she goes using her ultimate ability, even though her energy bar wasn't completely full. And yeah, it looks like she's actually gaining some energy quite fast here. And gaining even more Feathers of Fate. And it looks like she can only use her ultimate with the energy as soon as she does her ultimate with the Feathers of Fate. So if you give her... I don't know about that energy there, but it doesn't seem to be going off, because it did say that it will use her ultimate again when she has her energy bar full, but it doesn't seem to be doing that so far. But overall, seems that she's taking down these enemies pretty quickly here. Yeah, just took them down pretty fast. And overall, sounds like Trishea will be a very useful hero. I'm definitely going to build her, especially since she's a wilder. It's pretty easy to build these main 4 faction heroes. Combined with how good she looks, the whole space theme I really like I said. And yeah, just the fact that she's a part of the main 4 faction heroes. I will definitely be building Trishea. Hey, if you like this video, make sure to like and subscribe. Also comment what do you think about Trishea, and there will be a video on screen that YouTube thinks you would like to watch next. So go ahead and click on that video, and thanks for watching.